It's another hockey game, but it was more to me and Jamie.
I just told myself I was going to score that game. Hockey was obviously a big part of Larry in my life. I can't even explain just how special a person he was to me.
If it was a thankless job, that was Dad's favorite job.
On the North Saanich Peninsula, for almost 20 years, children and their parents have been stopping at the house on McTavish Road. It was here Larry Orr shaped hockey dreams for a generation. And it all started sharpening skates in his garage.
Larry just came home one day and said, guess what? I bought a skate sharpening machine. And I'm going, oh, really? So he just tore the garage apart, put the skate sharpening machine in, and taught himself how to sharpen skates.
The thing that really stood out was how quickly it grew, and you know, we had to renovate the garage to make it friendly for people to come in, and then it just turned into this spot.
I call it his office. It's so simple, but yet it's so special to us and for the kids in the peninsula.
You know, we would sit in there for hours and just chat and then watch him do his thing on the skate sharpener.
To see him mean something like that to a lot of other people was awesome.
The shop space could never grow, but its impact sure did, especially when Larry decided to launch an equipment share program.
You could see the look, like it just sort of came from his toes right all the way up. That just made him feel so good.
Where he found enjoyment was to do the things that didn't need recognition. If it was a thankless job, that was Dad's favorite job.
If things were returned to Larry that somebody didn't need, it was put on the shelf for somebody that needed it.
And the parents, well, how much is that? And Larry just loves saying nothing. It's free.
Everything Larry did was for the kids. Some of them who first walked into Larry's shop before they could skate go on to play for the Junior B Peninsula Panthers. And it was no surprise Larry found a way to be there.
Larry was the heart and soul of the team, equipment manager, skate sharpener, and just basically kept the guys in check all the way along.
You know, playing for the Panthers as a 16-year-old, going into this big team, and you know, he was kind of the comfort zone that you could lean on. Whenever you needed something, he was the guy to go to.
Larry's relationship with Jamie and Jordy Benn may have started with sharpening their skates in his garage, but it grew deeper when they played for the Panthers and made their way to the NHL.
He's almost like a second father. You know, you could go to him with any problems, and he'd be there to listen and help you out with whatever you needed.
As we got older, the friendship just blossomed. Anytime I ever left his house, I always told him I loved him, just so he would know.
Last spring, North Saanich was selected as the host of Kraft Hockeyville. A small community would get the opportunity to host an NHL Sharks Canucks preseason game. Larry was asked if he would drop the puck.
His reaction originally was no, again. But he understood that we wanted to do this for him and for our community, to show everyone what we knew for so many years, that people like Larry, they're valued, and we appreciate everything they do for us.
Larry got sick, majorly sick, and you could tell. And Randy was around a lot, and he wanted to tell Jamie and Jordy about it, and Larry had said, no, don't tell them, they've got enough on their plates right now.
I got a text from my dad after practice one day and said that Larry wasn't doing too good.
You know, we were on that flight pretty quick, and you know, at Larry's a couple days later, just checking up on him.
It wasn't a little thing, it was very big. It was a very big thing for them to do.
We knew how special he was to us, and just let him know that we appreciate everything he's done, we love you, and hopefully see you soon.
It was amazing. Lovely weekend.
Larry had been diagnosed with lung and liver cancer. The prognosis was not good. What started as a matter of months quickly became a matter of weeks. As Kraft Hockeyville approached, Larry battled to make it to the event.
A little more than a week before the puck drop, I phoned Derek and I said, GD, I'm kind of worried.
That was when it really kind of set in that, you know, we had known he was sick. We didn't quite know how sick at that point.
But he said, you know, if they have to carry me out, I'm going to drop that puck.
Please welcome longtime North Saanich hockey volunteer Larry Orr to center ice.
You know, you wish the carpet was 300 yards because you just wanted it to last forever.
There was a lot of people from the peninsula at that game, and it was good for them to have the chance to stand up and standing ovation, have a chance to say thanks, Larry.
Him being able to do that, being that sick, we were walking back to say that was pretty neat. And hearing him say that was extremely special.
On September 29th, 2015, 8 days after he stepped to center ice, Larry Orr passed away. On a West Coast fall day, the community came out to celebrate Larry's life at the rink where his impact affected so many young lives. Stuck at work, his two greatest admirers reached out to Larry in the best possible way.
It was a tough day. At the same time, I had to focus on a task at hand, and that was playing a hockey game at night.
It's another hockey game, but it was more, I guess, to me and Jamie.
And this game heads to overtime, tied at three.
I just told myself I was going to score that game. I don't know when, but I'm going to do it, and I know what I'm going to do after.
Benchuk to score! Jamie Benn overtime!
It was pretty emotional. Hockey was obviously a big part of Larry and my life.
When he pointed to the ceiling, it was kind of just like a thank you to Larry.
It brings tears to your eyes because you lost such a special person in your life. I can't even explain just how special of a person he was to me and everyone on the peninsula.